Hi everyone, this video is going to go over how you can find and download SPSS onto your personal desktop. So the first thing that we want to do is go to your single sign-on page. Now the university has updated their single sign-on website, so instead of csulb.okta.com, we'll go there first just so you can see, but they have a link that will redirect you to the new Microsoft Apps page, which is now, I guess, our single sign-on. So I've created a favorites collection of applications of things that I use on a common day-to-day basis. You can do this by using the Create tool up in the right-hand corner. If you log in though, you will notice that you just have all of your Long Beach apps, and there's a ton of them, right? Different icons, so you know, get yourself familiar if you use any of these things regularly. The one that we're going to be interested for this particular video is the Software Depot, or it'll say Campus Software. So let's go ahead and click on that link. And since we're already logged in, we should be directed to a page that looks something like this. Instead of faculty and staff, you should say student. In the product search, just type SPSS. And then go ahead and just collapse this first option. So you'll see that SPSS comes in both an AMIS version and a statistics version. You want the statistics versions. I will have all of our statistics videos updated to version 27. So if you want to download this one, that's great. I do know in the past that some version numbers tend to work better for some computers versus others, so like Mac versus Windows. But I'm going to choose a Mac because that's what I'm working off of. I'll add it to my cart. View full cart. And then you'll see it's free, yay, right? Make sure you click that you're placing the order for yourself and you're going to check out. Make sure your contact information is correct, okay? And then you are not a robot and proceed with the order. You'll notice then that you are provided with the download link area and there's an authorization code in red. Okay. Now you'll notice also under here that there is the academic year that this license would be available for. So I actually already have this downloaded on my computer, and my access will be valid through July 31st of 2021. So after July 31st passes, none of you should run into this problem because I'm making this video prior to the fall semester. But you'll notice that the academic year should be changed to 2021-2022, and the license should expire by July 31st of 2022. But pretty much all you're going to do is click download, and then basically run the installer, follow the instructions from there. And I would save this screen because it has your authorization code once the app is live. If you're in a Windows computer, you can either search in the search bar SPSS and you should find the application pretty easily. If you're in a Mac like myself, you can press the F4 button on your keyboard, or you can activate your launch pad and then you'll see SPSS statistics. Okay, so once you click on that the first time running through, it's not going to show on my computer because I've already entered my authorization code, but once you click on it for the first time, it'll ask you for some licensing information. You get your, just say you already have a license, you put in the authorization code, and you should be good to go. But if you guys have any problems with the download, please let me know, and I'd be happy to help you the best that I can. All right?